Checking your blood glucose is important to help you make decisions about your diabetes. Having blood glucose records is also important to help your healthcare team work with you to make sure you are on diabetes therapy that works best for you. Glucose values help measure how your body responds to different therapies and if you are meeting your blood glucose goals. Checking your blood glucose can help you understand how what you eat, physical activity, and medications affect blood glucose levels. Using a glucose meter with a finger stick glucose is helpful, but only provides a small amount of glucose data points for each day. This also requires you to keep your meter, lancets, test strips, and alcohol swabs with you, and stick your finger to check your blood glucose. This can be a lot to manage every day. The use of continuous glucose monitors, or CGMs, has become more popular in recent years in patients with both type 1 diabetes and type 2 diabetes, as well as other forms of diabetes such as gestational diabetes. Continuous glucose monitors provide benefits to both patients and the healthcare team in understanding and making decisions on how to treat diabetes. While this innovative technology is different and requires you to learn some new skills to use, it may be transformational in how you and your healthcare team are able to improve your diabetes care. What is a CGM? A continuous glucose monitor, or CGM, is a device that automatically tracks glucose, measuring the interstitial glucose. This allows you to monitor your glucose immediately without requiring a finger stick. CGMs also provide information about glucose trends, which may help you better understand how medications, food, and activity are changing your glucose values. A CGM can help you know what your glucose is currently and which direction it is trending. A CGM can help assess glycemic variability, patterns in your glucose values, and hypoglycemia better than A1C. This is important as glycemic variability or significant changes in your blood glucose throughout the day can increase your risk of hypoglycemia or low blood glucose. Variability is also associated with increased risk of diabetes complications such as heart or kidney disease. How does a CGM work? Continuous glucose monitors work by measuring the glucose level of the interstitial fluid surrounding the cells in tissues of your muscles. This has been shown to measure glucose values similar to the glucose level in your blood. It is important to know there is a lag time when glucose levels are rapidly rising or falling. When this happens, the glucose readings on the CGM may lag up to 15 minutes behind a fingerstick blood glucose. Depending on which CGM product you use, CGMs measure interstitial glucose every 1 to 5 minutes. If you are using a real-time CGM, the glucose value will be automatically transmitted to your CGM receiver or smartphone. If you are using an intermittently scanned CGM product, then you will have to swipe the receiver, reader, or smartphone over the sensor to get the glucose information. There are several important parts of a CGM to be familiar with. The sensor is the part of the CGM that is inserted under the skin and measures the interstitial glucose. CGMs also utilize a transmitter, which is attached to the sensor and sends the glucose values wirelessly to either a receiver or reader. Transmitters may be reusable or disposable, depending on the product. To view the glucose data, you will need either a receiver, also called a reader sometimes, or a compatible smartphone or device. When viewing the glucose data, you will be able to see your real-time glucose value, as well as trend arrows showing the direction the glucose is heading. These trend arrows can help you identify and prevent both low and high glucoses. What are the differences between CGM products? There are both personal and professional CGM devices currently available. Professional devices are applied by your healthcare team to better understand glucose patterns and make treatment decisions. Professional CGM devices are placed by your healthcare provider, and you will wear a CGM device for a brief period of time, usually 7 to 14 days, and then have that information downloaded and reviewed by your healthcare team. A personal CGM is owned by a patient and allows you to use the information from your CGM to make decisions about your glucose. You can share your glucose data in real time, remotely with family members, caretakers, or friends, and your healthcare team. There are other differences between CGM products which may make a difference in which product works best for you. Differences include alerts and alarms and how you can share information remotely. Some devices may also require calibration with a finger stick blood glucose. Additionally, the number of days you can wear the sensor is different between products, as is where on your body you can wear it, and applications and software compatibility. Most CGMs have an application or app for smartphones or a reader device you can use to look at your glucose data. This will allow you to view your current glucose levels with arrows indicating the direction where your glucose is heading. You can also look back at past glucose values and trends. These differences between the products allow for you to work with your healthcare team to find which product best meets your glucose monitoring needs. How do I get a CGM? The first thing you need is an order for a CGM from your healthcare provider. This will include prescriptions for a sensor, transmitter, and receiver. If the CGM works with your smartphone or insulin pump, and that is how you prefer to view your glucose, then you will not need a prescription for the receiver. Insurance providers have increased coverage for CGMs in recent years, but the requirements and even how they cover these products vary significantly. Some insurance providers cover CGM supplies through durable medical equipment benefits, while others cover them under prescription benefits. This can make a difference in how much you pay for their CGM supplies, whether you can get them at the pharmacy or through a medical supply company, and what requirements there are to qualify for coverage of a CGM. Figuring out this process can require some time and research for both you and your healthcare team. Once you have your device, it is important to get education on how to apply and utilize your device. Meeting with a certified diabetes care and education specialist, sometimes called a diabetes educator, can help you make sure you use your CGM correctly, including knowing what to do with the numbers you see and what to do if something goes wrong. Some important things you will need to learn include the following: how to apply the sensor and transmitter, as well as connect this technology to your receiver or smartphone. Understand how the sensor works, why there may be differences between a finger stick and your CGM, how to react to trends in blood glucose, and knowing when to contact your healthcare provider. As you set up your CGM, an educator will help you set up the alarms correctly and make sure they fit your glucose goals. They will also teach you what you should do when you have alarms for both high and low glucose values. How will using a CGM help you? There are many benefits that you may see from using a CGM to monitor your glucose. Understanding what your glucose is doing throughout the entire day can help you identify patterns in your glucose. A CGM also lets you know what your current glucose is without having to do a finger stick, and lets you know where your glucose is heading. Alerts can be used to help you prevent and quickly treat both low and high glucose values. CGM's glucose values help you to better understand how lifestyle, diet, and medications affect your glucose. You can also share glucose readings with a family member or caregiver, which can help keep you safe as you manage your diabetes. Decreasing finger stick glucoses may also make it easier for you to manage your diabetes daily. How does using a CGM help my healthcare team? There are many ways that the healthcare team also benefits when you use a CGM for glucose monitoring. When working with you to make decisions about your diabetes, CGMs provide enhanced glucose metrics, including time in range, time spent with hyperglycemia, time spent with hypoglycemia, and glycemic variability. Your provider is also able to view glucose values throughout the entire day, not limited to when you perform a fingerstick blood glucose. This data is important in making sure your diabetes therapy fits your individual glucose patterns. All CGM products have the ability for a device download that can be evaluated by the healthcare team, so you will want to bring it with you to appointments for your provider to view. Things a provider will be able to look at include average glucose, glycemic variability, and time in range. Would I benefit from using a CGM? CGMs are not a one-size-fits-all, but here are some of the people with diabetes that may especially benefit from using a CGM. Patients who use multiple daily injections of insulin. Those utilizing an insulin pump or considering utilizing an insulin pump in the future. For these patients, it is important to consider which CGM may integrate with the patient's pump. Patients who have frequent or severe low glucose values. Patients who do not have symptoms of low glucose when their glucose drops. Those that have a lot of glucose fluctuations throughout the day. Any patient who is not achieving their glucose goals. No matter why you are using a CGM, having diabetes education, training, and support are important for you when starting and continuing to use a CGM. CGM device companies offer online training videos and education support, which can be helpful for both initial training and fixing any issues with CGM technology. Having in-person training with a certified diabetes care and education specialist can help you become more comfortable with the technology. What things might prevent me being successful using my CGM? While in recent years, CGMs have become more accessible, cost and coverage of the devices continues to be a barrier and can be challenging to navigate. Insurance payer requirements for coverage of a patient to utilize CGMs can vary. For example, some insurance companies may require you to utilize insulin or have documented hypoglycemia in your medical record to cover a CGM, while others may not have any requirements. It is also important to note, under some insurances, CGMs are covered as durable medical equipment through your medical insurance benefits, whereas other insurance plans cover it as a prescription benefit where you can fill through local pharmacies. Most insurance payers do have a preferred CGM product on their formulary, so this may limit which device you can use. Your out-of-pocket cost for the technology may also vary. This may include copay or coinsurance, and deductibles may also apply. Some CGMs will require you to calibrate or recalibrate the device with a fingerstick blood glucose. You also may need additional time and skills to manage the CGM technology, which can sometimes take a while to get used to. While the 24/7 blood glucose monitoring can be extremely helpful, it can also lead to information overload for some patients. Making sure your goals and alarms are set up specific to your glucose goals can help you not get tired or frustrated with the CGM alarms. Using a CGM also requires you to wear something attached to your body to use, which may take some getting used to. As the CGMs utilize adhesives, issues may arise with this. Skin reactions can sometimes occur that may be due to irritation or an allergy. Additionally, some people have difficulty with adhesive lasting the duration of the sensor. How can I be successful in using CGM? One of the most important ways to make sure using a CGM improves your diabetes management is getting appropriate education on managing the device. Working with a certified diabetes care and education specialist when setting up your CGM for the first time or when having difficulty with using a CGM. You should be prepared to contact your insurance provider, benefits manager, pharmacy, and a durable medical equipment supplier if needed to receive the device through your insurance. It is also important to be ready to work through issues that may arise with your continuous glucose monitor. This may include issues in insurance coverage of the CGM or even actual issues with technology working correctly. You should be prepared to contact the manufacturer of your product if you have connectivity issues, errors, or malfunctioning equipment. How can I find out more information about using a CGM? The Barnstable Brown Diabetes Center at the University of Kentucky Healthcare offers a variety of diabetes education services for patients, including CGM education appointments. A certified diabetes care and education specialist will meet with you to provide education and support the skills needed for successful CGM use. Additionally, there are many resources available for both patients and healthcare staff through a variety of diabetes organizations and companies that manufacture CGMs.